follow me.
Last night was Pepsi tax challenge and the housemates came with a banger, like they came with their 100%. Hi guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Vicky. Welcome to my channel. If you're seeing my face for the very first time, please consider to hit on that red subscribe button by your right hand side and subscribe to my channel, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell so that YouTube will inform you whenever I post a new video. And please give this video a thumbs up if you do enjoy it. Don't forget to leave me a comment in the comment section. Oh guys, what happened yesterday night? You see, I was so tired and I could not bring this video to you guys, but yeah, better late than never. And also, you know, leave the good for the last, yeah, that kind of thing. So yesterday Pepsi came to the house to give the housemates their task, you know, and one of the tasks was to solve a puzzle, whichever puzzle that you actually solve. Maybe you solve the puzzle and the face of the artist on the puzzle will be the one you'll be in that person's team.
Don't take shit.
Who is that, you know?
No, don't do that now. Which one is find your copy?
And we had different teams and different housemates in their team. The housemates were paired in two teams, which I'll be running you through on. We have team Davido, which is Dorothy and Brighto. We have team Bonaboy, which is New and Erica. We have team DJ Copy, which is Kidwire and Lucy. We have team Techno, which is Ozo and Trickytee. We have team Whiskey, which is Laycon and Wathoni. And then we have DJ Spinal, which is Tolani Badge and V. The first part of the task was for them to also do a rehearsal. You get, they gave them a song and the lyrics of the people that they are in their team. Like they gave Dorothy and Brighto the Davido song to practice and the lyrics so that they'll be able to go through it. You get,
you marry me, you go love me, you go killing me baby, you go follow me, you be my remedy.
And first of all, the first part of the task, which is like solving that puzzle, it was team Tiwa Savage that actually won, which is the team of Prince and Nengi. It was time for them to do their task presentation. The whole arena, I don't know if that place is arena, but it was so colorful the way Pepsi came and decorated the whole place. And they came and all they were asked to do was them, they play the sound, like the beats to them, and they sing the song without the artist singing. You get, it started with team Davido, they sang the song and then the whole team ran their songs through. You get, and the most exciting thing, or the most exciting part of this thing, is, you know, after the Whiskey team, which is Laycon and Wathoni, after they finished singing, at the end of their song, you get, they actually kissed. And I'm like, eh? Are you guys trying to make us wonder if you are, you guys actually kissed, just like we are wondering how Tiwa Savage also kissed Whiskey at the end of that song? Because they were singing this, I don't know, one little say one little. That's the song they were singing. I know Tiwa Savage was a video vixen on that song for Whiskey, which actually buzzed the internet. The people that really made this show interesting, which me for one, I was in support of their win, was the team of Trickytee and also, seriously, those people actually put in their best, their choreography, because after all, Big Brother was supposed to judge their scores from, let me read it out to you. Housemates will be judged based on teamwork, accuracy of lyrics and showmanship. So these people came up with their best, like their showmanship, their choreography was top-notch, their lyrics, they did not miss anyone.
See this love I see for your eyes, oh hey. I love you baby, you're nothing I'm twice, oh Shinga, yeah, your beauty making me to realize, oh baby say never.
Their teamwork was just there, you get, they did a whole lot, you get, and at the end of the day, they're the ones that won the tax, you get, and they were given a prize of 1,000,000 naira each and an all expense paid trip to One Music Fest in Dubai.
The Pepsi Turn Up Task winner is Team Techno.
It's alive.
Hey, see enjoyment for these people, Trickytee. You know, God of Trickytee has been doing it for Trickytee. Trickytee has been standing for 3 weeks without being evicted, and then 1 year of Pepsi supply. I am like, hey, that means there's a reason that God has actually been keeping Trickytee. At this very point, I'm sure if Trickytee is leaving the show, he will be like, thank God I did not go losing, because this is the biggest tax, as in the biggest win, 1 million naira, all expense paid trip, and then 1 year supply. So if you lose that, it's better than others that actually went without winning such a huge prize you get. So I'm really, really happy and elated for Trickytee, as in, guys, me, I'm super duper happy for this guy, because it's been something else. And trust me, they end it, I'm not saying out of pity or something, but they actually end it, like the video you watch, they really end it, because their choreography was top notch. In fact, when they were singing their own, I was really impressed. I even started dancing.
Oh, you got to give me, oh, baby, Palanga. I will show you love that you never seen. Palanga, and you're the mother of my two, baby, baby, Palanga. And if you want, we make a TV, baby, baby, Palanga. I would love it.
Yeah, so that's just it. And then at the end of the day, Prince was just a sore loser. Prince was really angry. He was angry at Nengi, saying that Nengi actually did not do what they planned on doing, that they planned on doing the choreography, since they were the one that actually won the tax of the puzzle. And this is like a two-step tax. If you win the first step, you just need an extra effort so that you can win the second step and you be the one to win. And Nengi did not sing. Nengi, it was just truly, Nengi actually did not sing in the showcase of their whatever. She was just acting as a video vixen, whereas when they were doing the rehearsal, she was singing. There was a part she was supposed to sing, and you see that in that particular aspect, Prince was the one that actually covered that up.
They get at the something they do me for body, oh.
All over, all over.
I make you spend this money, oh.
Hey. All over, all over.
Now because of you, hey, I get the goosebumps, oh.
All over, all over.
Hey. This feeling got me far.
Even when Prince was even thinking, I was like, Jesus Christ, this guy really needs this win, because the way he's really doing it with muscle, guy was like, I really need to win this. Because lately in the house, in fact, since Prince actually came into the house, Prince has been having this near success syndrome kind of thing you get. And I really feel for him, because sometimes it can be really annoying when you know that you're always close to success. Even in the head of house games, most of the games in the house, Prince, most of the things happening in the house, Prince is always coming so close, like that thing, like this, that near success syndrome. So he complained. First of all, he was just feeling down.
Cool. When he says that thing,
when I looked everywhere, I'm like, ah, where is Tricky? Where is
Prince?
I knew this is what's going on. Shakira.
See him talking to Wathoni and Trickytee consoling him and all that, and then he now went ahead to also speak with Tolani Badge, complaining to Tolani Badge how much of, like, blaming Nengi per se.
Before the show starts, before the rehearsal, I told Nengi, you have to bring all the energy, because I know T and V are going to bring so much energy. Because you guys saw, I was scared of you guys saw, but you guys saw. Had so much energy. So I was also really banking on at least my performance, we're going to kill our own.
What he was actually doing was, he was blaming Nengi, because Nengi was actually not doing her part of the whole show, her part of the thing, because I think she actually forgot her lines, which is what happened to most of the housemates that did their own performance. When they were performing, most of the housemates, they one time or the other forgot their lyrics, forgot their lines, you get. So that was actually what made them not to score this thing, because there was a time where it was time for Nengi to sing her part of the music, and then she could not remember her lines. And you see Prince covering up for her, and that was just it. So he was really, really angry. He really felt bad. And trust me, in the process of him feeling bad, it actually paid for him. Oh yeah, you heard me. Because Pepsi saw his cries, Pepsi saw his complaints, and they said that Nengi and Prince, for winning the first part of the game, which is the puzzle part, that they will be giving an all expense paid trip to Dubai for the One Music Fest. So sometimes it is good to complain when you feel like you're feeling down, you get. So at the end of the day, though they have not announced it to them before I make this video, so but that is what the Pepsi handle actually tweeted, and Tiwa Savage was happy. So that's just it. Now it is Ozo, Nengi, Prince and Trickytee that will be traveling to Dubai. And you know, for some reason, and this one that Ozo is going, I would have just, if it was Prince and Nengi that won it, I would now be like, oh really, let something not happen in that Dubai, because we all know that Prince likes Nengi. But now Ozo will be there to actually keep an eye on them and be like a hawk and be like, this is my girl, or something like that. So that's basically what I just came to tell you. Pepsi brought their tax into the house, and the housemate did it, and Trickytee and Ozo came out as the winner. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment in the comment section, and please do not forget to subscribe if you haven't. Yeah, subscribe to the channel, turn on your notification bell so that YouTube will inform you whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll most definitely see you in my next video. Bye guys.